You may not have been aware of a significant Visual Studio Code development announcement in April 2022. The Python extension for Visual Studio Code has undergone a transformation to enhance its performance and stability. The focus has now shifted towards delivering a more streamlined experience by separating the tool's support into individual extensions. You may have already noticed that in the extensions, you can now go ahead and install PyLint, Flake 8, Black Formatter, AutoPEP 8, iSort, and that's now all available from the extensions. Within many of our tutorials and courses, we have been promoting the idea of installing common linting and formatting tools through Python Package Index and then configuring them with Visual Studio Code through a settings file. You may have alternatively been using the Visual Code settings, and then searching for Python. You can see here a range of different Python related settings. So as Visual Studio Code is now transitioning to this new extension model, certain adjustments will need to be made. So built-in support for linters and formatters will no longer be available within the Python extension. So consequently, several settings will be deprecating and removed. Now, if you already are using this approach of using settings, if you hover over it, we're now actually told the setting will soon be deprecated, and we're potentially then asked to actually install the extensions from the extension area. So it's going to be a little bit impractical for me to go through every single tutorial that I've created and then identify where we have included these type of settings. So I am asking you, the community, if you can help, if you do find any tutorials with this setup or similar setup where we're utilizing settings to configure linters and formatters in Python, if you can just leave a comment in the comments for anyone else who may stumble upon the tutorial, maybe wondering why it doesn't work, that will be most appreciated. No doubt, as we transition over to utilizing extensions, the extensions will start to provide choices and options and configurations for us to simulate the environments that we've been creating thus far. If you take a look at some of the documentation, we can see that there are some other alternatives for deprecated settings that have been provided by Visual Studio Code. One of them is that we can create a task to run the tool automatically in the terminal. So one of the settings that we created was to run these tools black, for example, whenever we saved, we would automatically run black. Now, of course, we can still continue utilizing these tools in the command line, but it might be quite interesting for us to explore some of the settings that are provided by the extension and then potentially have a look at some other customizations to try and replicate the environment, the configuration that we have previously created. So over the next couple of weeks and months, we'll go ahead and try to create some new tutorials to help you create new custom workflows utilizing this alternative and new approach.